Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. We're not cooking in Betty's Kitchen today because I'm going to show you how you may watch Betty's Kitchen on TV. To do that, you need to have a device hooked up to your TV, and this is a Roku device. And it's a streaming video player allowing you to get movies, games, music, and even cooking channels on your TV. So I'm going to pick up my remote here, which I will be using to navigate this. And you can see this is where I'm starting. So I need to go to the right, use the right arrow, and get over to iFood.tv and press OK, the center button, to choose that. It takes a few seconds for it to load. Just wait, it's coming. And when we get to this page, you can see some of the things that are on iFood.tv. We're on the line that is highlighted here in the center and has a blurb about it. And this happens to be the line that says recently watched, so you can tell what I've been watching recently. I guess I was checking out what I was doing in each one of those. And if we go down a little bit, you can see most popular, and then best, new, and Betty's Kitchen will be in here occasionally, but most often it will be other kitchens or other channels, which you probably are familiar with. You can see many of the categories that you could search, or just you can go down very fast like this, and it has to catch up with you a little bit. But what I want to do is to go back to the top. And get to the top line. And if I go right, there are some channels that you might be interested in. Happy Kids, Health Smart, Trip Smart, Style, iStyle, Fit You. You can see if you're interested in fitness or fashion or some of those other topics, they are there. Out here at the end are some international food channels. So I didn't want to omit those possibilities for you. I'm coming back to the left and I'm going down to where it says home again and let you see that if I wanted to log out, I could do that. If I wanted to search for a particular title of recipe or just give it a few of the letters, it will fill in and autofill the rest of the title maybe for you. Shows are some of the channels that you could watch. Dish would be something like roast beef or grilled steak, something. Ingredients, if you have certain ingredients you want to search for, like tomato dishes or something like that, you could press OK on that and do that search. Method is like grilling, broiling, baking, boiling, anything like that. Cuisine, different international cuisines. Course, that would be like maybe your entree, dessert, something like that. Specialty would be 4th of July, maybe Christmas, and so on. Vegetarian, taste. And now we start out with some kitchens, some channels. This one is, these are alphabetical, and this one is Amateur Kitchen. You've probably heard of that. And here are very familiar names, Ballistic Barbecue, Barbecue Pit Boys, and with this being alphabetical, Betty's Kitchen is the next one up, so that's where I was trying to get you to eventually. I'm going to press OK in the center, and everything that appears from here down will be Betty's Kitchen items. So I think I'll just stay there in the center column and just go down quickly and let you see the categories, because that's going to be the important thing for you, to be able to go to a category and find something that you want that's a casserole for dinner, or maybe the dessert that you want to take to a potluck or something like that. So just going down, you can see Father's Day, and then summer recipes, appetizer, baked, beef, cake, casserole, chicken, cookie, dessert, Easter, European. And by the way, I want to say up in the upper right hand corner, you'll see something that looks like a date, but this is the third one in out of 20 total in this particular line, and it will be circular. If you get to the end of it, then it will just repeat. Going on down, we have French, grilled, high protein, holiday, Italian, kids, lacto-ovo vegetarian, low calorie, main dish, Mexican, party, pies, roasted, salad, sandwich, South American, Southern, traditional, and then we're back to some of those channels that you saw up at the top. So that gives you a fairly complete organizational structure of Betty's Kitchen, so you can find things more readily than you have been if you like to use this particular format. Also, the widescreen TV is nice and comfortable if you want to sit on your sofa and watch a video. That's kind of nice, but totally up to you as to what you want to do in terms of watching any of the channels. Now let's go back up toward the top and just pick one of these, say this one, and start playing it. And when you start playing it, you just press the OK in the center there. It has to load for a minute, well, for a few seconds. And then it will start out. I have this muted, so it's not conflicting with our discussion, but you know, that's the way my videos start nowadays. And it would go on to play that. While a video is playing, you can press the down arrow and you can get some options. Let's go right and get that eye. And you can see the ingredient list here for that particular recipe, and you'll see something similar on the others. The heart over at the right is if you want to favorite it, so you can come back to it sometime. And then there's a search and a few other options that you saw there. I've shown you a few things about Betty's Kitchen from inside the app that is called iFood.tv. And I did that so you could see that there are a lot of channels in iFood.tv that you might be interested in, since you watch maybe cooking channels. And there are a lot of cooking channels, but there are others as well, like the fitness and health and so on. But also I want you to know that Betty's Kitchen is a distinct and separate app from iFood.tv. So I've come back to the home screen where my channels is highlighted, and I have added the channel Betty's Kitchen. You just type in Betty's Kitchen and it will recognize it probably after the word Betty's, and it will locate it for you, and you can do add channel. And then the icon for Betty's Kitchen comes up. So let's go to that for a moment to show you. If you use this as a separate app, distinct from iFood.tv, then what you're going to get is this look. It's going to be loading for a few seconds, and then you have your functions that you can do up here at the top, and the categories are the ones that I showed you when we were working within iFood.tv. So nothing really new here. I just wanted to show you that if all you wanted to watch was Betty's Kitchen, since you are here now, you could set that up as one of your channels, and then you could go directly to it instead of going through another channel to get to it. It is its own app. I hope that demonstration was sufficient to show you how to navigate the system, and it's really kind of neat because Betty's Kitchen is so much more organized in this fashion than it is on my channel on YouTube. You probably noticed in the title that I have a Roku giveaway. So now we're going to talk about that. The Roku giveaway will be for one lucky winner, a Roku receiver and player, which is this, along with the accompanying remote that you need to operate that. And it comes in a box like this. You can see there the two items that are going to be in that box. Now, the rules of the contest, I want to put my glasses on and have this in front of me so that we're all on the same page. I want to get this exactly perfect. This giveaway has already begun. It began last night at midnight, 12 a.m. midnight on July the 11th, 2014. It will last 3 full days and end at 12 a.m. midnight on June the 14th, 2014. A winner, one winner, will be chosen by random drawing. To enter, what you need to do is leave a comment on this video answering the following question. Apart from YouTube, which other platform are you most likely to watch me on? Would it be Roku, Android, operating system, which would include iPhone and iPad, Windows, Amazon? And also tell why you would want to see me on a platform other than YouTube, if that is the case. When you make your comment, you may think, oh, I meant to say something else. You can make other comments, but the first comment will be your entry into the contest. All the others will just be non-existent. And I do have to announce that this contest is open to U.S. residents only. And I'm very sorry about that, but after the winner is determined, the information will be collected from the winner and be sent on to iFood.tv, and they will take care of sending out the Roku devices and controllers. So good luck to all of you. I know not everyone is going to win. There's just going to be one lucky winner, but I wish you luck, and I hope we get some good information from you from that question that I asked.